Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this District 1 6A matchup between the Eastwood Troopers and the visiting El Dorado Aztecs. My name is Alex Sanchez, and I'm here with my co-host, Christian Ray Baeza. Crab, what do you have to say about the Aztecs coming into this game against the number 2 team in the district, the Eastwood Troopers?
You know, this is going to be a very tough game for the Aztecs. They are 4-16 in their overall record, which is, you know, it's going to be a tough game for the Aztecs. They have to come over Steven Serna, who is a very good pitcher for the Troopers.
Serna on the mound, number 4, Elijah Issa up to bat. Dropped by number 15, Noah Nunez. Issa does get to first. Nunez could have had a very quick first out for the Troopers, but drops it. Issa, on first. Number 3, Diego Madrid up to bat next. Serna talking to his catcher, discussing what might be their next pitch and how they're going to go at it so they can get the Aztecs off the field. Foul ball. Number 11, Sebastian Lasguadain, the catcher for the Troopers today. Serna up to pitch. Issa on first still. Was looking like he was about to steal that. Made the right decision to stay back.
You know, I think the batter was showing bunt there. Maybe wanted to advance the runner. Maybe get him in scoring position a second.
Gabe Hernandez creeping up. And that'll be safe. Issa steals second.
And, you know, that's what he wanted to do. He's been wanting to do that, I think, since he got on base. And, you know, Steven made the right decision with throwing to first, but he just couldn't get him out in time.
Issa did look like he was trying to get to second as quickly as possible and then just made the split decision to get it, and it paid off.
Yeah.
Now inching towards third. Serna looking back. Issa running to third. Serna throws it to first, and that is out. Madrid will be out.
But Issa did advance to third, so any contact from the batter right here will get him 15, home.
Abraham. Next batter up, number 15, Abraham Poldillo, up to bat for the Aztecs. Aztecs do have a runner on third.
That is ball one.
Issa creeping towards home. Serna hits it, and that is a line drive down the middle. Gets to home. It'll be out. Aztecs do not get that point. Second out for the Aztecs. That's crucial right there. Getting it from second base all the way to home before Issa can make it home.
And, you know, that stops El Dorado from getting an early, early lead in this, which really helps the Troopers over here.
It's plays like that is the reason why the Troopers are as good as they are. Coming off the district, 6-1, they're second in their district. Their last loss was against America's, their only district loss.
At number one, Derek Gonzalez came in a pinch run for Abraham Pulido.
Christian Diaz up to bat for the Aztecs. Serna communicating with Lasguadain.
That is ball two.
Ball three for the Troopers. One more and he walks. Zero strikes so far.
Two outs.
Maybe first strike called for the Troopers.
That is strike two, so it'll be a full count for Steven on this next pitch, hoping to get him out and retire the Aztecs and send his offense out there.
Cerner can get off his team off the field now with this pitch.
And he does it.
So the Troopers will come back on the field right now with their offense. And we are back for the bottom of the first inning. Score is 0 for the Aztecs. Troopers batting up now. Diego Rivera up to bat for the Troopers. Rivera up to bat.
Ball one.
Low ball. That'll be ball two. Troy Morillo pitching for the Aztecs right now. It'll be a third ball. One more and Diego walks. First strike called in favor of the Aztecs. Moody on the mound. That'll be the fourth ball, and Diego will walk. His brother up next, Zosimo.
Now batting for the Troopers, number one, Zosimo Rivera.
Zosimo Rivera up to bat next for the Troopers. Diego Rivera's twin brother. Zosimo also actually kicked for our football team. Diego, however, kicked for our baseball team, our football team this year.
You know, there's a number of athletes on this baseball team that did play for the Troopers, and we will point them out to you when they are up to bat.
High ball, it'll be a foul. Murillo to pitch.
And Gabe Hernandez is on deck.
That'll be between second and third. Each brother
twins
on
first and second.
Gabe Hernandez up to bat, the junior.
Number 17, Gabe Hernandez.
Hernandez has been on varsity since his freshman year, as many of his teammates have been. So it shows that they are an experienced team at the varsity level.
Yeah, and you know, that helps a lot, especially with the experience level going into these games. You know, El Dorado, you know, it's a young pitcher on the mound. He's a sophomore. And having the varsity level that Gabe does for all 3 years so far really helps him.
Swing and a miss for Hernandez. First strike. Coach Mignol's trying to communicate with Hernandez. Didn't seem too happy. Gabe looking to swing, doesn't. The twins still on first and second. That'll be a high ball. Almost over Gabe's head. Two balls, one strike. Murillo up to pitch. Looking back at Diego. Foul ball called. It'll be Gabe's second strike. Coach Munoz again communicating with Gabe, trying to calm him down. His teammates are hyping him up. That'll be a far hit. Will it be caught? Yes, it will. Diego running the third, however, he makes it, slides and stays. Zosimo on first.
Now batting number six, Brandon Gomez.
Brandon Gomez, another player that's been on varsity since a freshman. You know, he's really strong. He's got the power to send this ball over the fence on any pitch.
Diego on third. Zosimo on first. Brandon, this is a third year on varsity, and he's shown that he deserves to be here. He's committed to UTRGV. That's an early commitment, but obviously it's paying off.
Yeah, you know, you want to get committed as early as you can. You know, you just guaranteed himself at least another 4 more years of baseball.
Zosimo gets to second, steals it. Ball did not get there in time, and it was dropped.
A lot of steals early from both these teams. You know, they're playing very aggressive, want to get ahead of this game as soon as they can.
Murillo communicating with his catcher, Abraham Portillo, I believe that is. The Twins on second and third. Brandon up to bat. Two balls, one strike, one out. Brandon swings. That'll be his second strike.
And he is looking for his second home run of the season. He only does have one. He just wants to get that one going.
If he can get a home run now, that'll give the Troopers an early lead, 3-0. I think the Troopers want to get the Aztecs out of this game as soon as possible.
I agree.
Low ball.
Full count for Brandon Gomez going into his next pitch.
If Brandon walks, the bases will be loaded, and that's a good look for the next batter. High ball. Brandon will have another attempt at it.
And Alex, if you're the pitcher, would you go for a pitch straight down the middle that'll try to get him out, or you want to have him chase a pitch outside the zone?
I'm just trying to get him out right here. Long ball by Brandon. High-oh. Will it be caught? Yes, it will. Diego running to home, and he'll get there. Troopers get their first points of the night.
Now batting number 11, Sebastian Lascurain.
While Brandon was out, he was able to get some points on the board for his team, which can be crucial in the long run. Lascurain up to bat.
There he is. Pick him up, baby.
First strike. High ball. Strike two. One more strike, and the Troopers are off the field. High ball. Zosimo still on second. Hasn't moved. Murillo communicating with his catcher. He swings and misses. Makes contact. He'll have another attempt. High ball. Zosimov tries to steal third, however, does not get it, so that'll be the end of the first inning. We'll be back to you shortly. And we are back. Number 13, Julian Portillo, batting for the Aztecs. Serna up on the mound.
Strike one.
Ground ball. Gets it to first, and he'll be out.
Quick first out for the Troopers. You know, which is good. Makes them get ahead in this inning early against the Aztecs. Number 7, Jacob Vadillo.
Good hit by Portillo. Just unlucky to be out.
Yeah.
Number 7, Jacob Vadillo. Up to bat. Vadillo gets his first strike. High ball. Hernandez catches it. Vadillo will be out. Two outs back to back for the Aztecs.
Not batting for the Aztecs.
Troopers look to be getting off the field quickly.
You know, and that not only helps them, but also Steven. He gets to have more innings pitched because he doesn't waste so many throws like early on.
Foul ball. Carlos Campos up to bat for the Aztecs. Low ball. 2 balls, 0 strikes. First strike. Second strike. One more and the Troopers are off the field. They want to conserve Cerna's arm as much as possible. The Aztecs still looking for their first district win. Ground ball, then that'll also be out. So the Troopers will get off the field and we'll be back at the bottom of the second. And we are back. Las Cuarenta up to bat again. First strike. Line drive, but it is caught. Sebastian will be out.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 19, Victor Quiñones.
Quiñones up to bat. Murillo on the mound. Far hit, will not be caught. Quiñones will get to first. He'll get to first comfortably.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 9, Corby Wagoner.
Corby Wagoner up to bat. Another multi-sport athlete as he played football for the Troopers this year as well.
Yeah, he was our safety. He was a pretty good safety for us. And, you know, it's just good to see them, like, multi-sports.
It looks good on their college resumes as well.
Oh, for sure, 100%.
Wagner up to bat. First strike called. Ball one. One ball, two strikes. Wagner wants to hit the ball now so he can get into the playing field. Two balls, one strike. Two balls, two strikes. Correction. Murillo pitches it. throws it to first. Correction. Throws it to first again. Really trying to get Victor out.
Yeah, I believe that the pitcher thinks he's going to steal, and maybe he'll catch him one of these times.
Far hit. Right in between outfield.
Oh, and he misses it.
Victor might get home. And he will. He'll make it home comfortably. Wagner runs home. And he'll make it.
And that's an inside the park home run.
Wagner really put the kids to bed, brother, as Sketch would say.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 15, Noah Nunez.
Beautiful hit by Wagner. It was a great hit, but was that deserving of an inside the park? Was that El Dorado messing up?
You know, from what I saw, the left fielder missed the ball and got all the way to the fence, and, you know, that's all Corby needed to get home. He does have that speed.
So he does get two runners home, himself and Victor. Number 15, Noah Nunez, batting for the Troopers at the moment. Murillo trying to find something. That'd be his second strike. Nunez will strike out.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 2, Isaiah Zamora.
Zamora, another former football player. How did he do with the football team?
You know, he did really good. He had a crucial pick against the Pebble Hill Spartans to kind of seal that game for us. And that kind of took our season off and led us into an undefeated district season.
Zamora to bat. Ground ball. Will he get to first? It's close. He's safe. The first baseman dropped the ball trying to tag him. So Zamora will be safe.
You know, El Dorado is making crucial mistakes early on, which is allowing Eastwood Troopers to get those runs in and get them men on base.
Diego back up to bat. He was our first batter of the night. And he is back with his personal walk-up music, you could say.
You know, and you don't hear that every day. And that is really cool to have his own name in a song.
Murillo up to bat. Up to pitch. Swing and a miss for Rivera. Throws it to first, trying to get him out. But Zamora will stay in play. Two outs for the Troopers. Eldo really wants to get him off the field now because they're starting to score, and that's not what you want.
You know, this has been a pretty long inning for him. He just wants to get out of this inning and kind of forget about it.
Swing and a miss again for Rivera. One ball, two strikes. Has to be a little more cautious with his swings, knowing if he swings and misses again, his team is off the field. Hey. And he'll hit it. Zamora will steal to second. Will it be caught? Yes, it is. So the Troopers will get off the field and will be back at the top of the third. And we are back. Top of the third. 3-0 Troopers. Serna pitching. Nathan Aguilar batting for the Aztecs. And it'll be out. First out for the Aztecs. That was a ground ball. The first baseman was able to pick it up and get back to first base before Aguilar made it to first. Sebastian Rodriguez up to bat for the Aztecs.
Strike one.
Ground ball, picked up by Corby, throws it to first, and it'll get there. Two outs on the Aztecs. Eastwood really not trying to stay on defense for too long.
No, and, you know, everyone behind Cerner is making that very possible. They're getting the ground outs that they need, and they're getting them quick.
Elijah Issa up to bat again for the Aztecs. First strike called.
Tires aside again. Another scoreless inning.
Three batters, three outs. And we are back. Bottom of the third. 3-0, Troopers lead. El Dorado still has yet to get on the board. Zosimo Rivera, will be up to bat. Ball one called.
That is ball two. Zosimo did single last time he was up, looking to recreate that again. Strike one. Two balls, one strike.
Low ball. Sorry, we call it strike. Murillo trying to get Zosimo out. And he will not. It would be a high ball, however. It is caught. So Zosimo will be out.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 17, Gabe Hernandez.
Hernandez back out to bat for the Troopers. His last bat, it was a pop out.
Last time, be ready.
One ball, zero strikes. Ground ball. Will he get to first?
Out.
He will not. Hernandez not having too much luck at bat today.
Number six, Brandon Gomez.
Gomez up to bat again. His last bat was also a pop out. Listening to a little much little TJ with those pop outs right now.
Polo G.
Zero balls, one strike. High ball. Another high ball. Zero balls, two strikes. High ball thrown by Murillo. His first ball against Brandon. Brandon will be out, and the Eldo Aztecs will get off the field quickly. We'll be back to you very shortly. And we are back. Top of the fourth. Still 3-0, Troopers lead. Diego Madrid up to bat. Ground ball. Will it get to first in time? Yes, it will. Diego will be out.
Now batting for the Aztecs, number 15, Abraham Pulido.
Pulido on his last bat. Had a good bat. Serna on the mound. And we are back. Sorry, we had some technical difficulties. Boldillo back up to bat.
Count is 2-2 with one out. One more strike and Serna retires Abraham.
Low ball.
Full count as Abraham awaits his next pitch.
High ball will be out. Looking at some cars.
Foul ball.
Hopefully no one's car's broken.
That's why I parked super far that way.
Another high ball. Count is still 3-2. Another foul ball.
You know, and he's really fighting to stay alive in this at bat.
I mean, this game is still far from over. We still have four more innings to go through. But that would be a ground ball. Sliding dive.
That was a smooth catch by Isaiah Zamora. Right,
that would be a third out, and we'll be back at the bottom of the fourth.
Nope, that's second out.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Second out. Number 9, Christian Diaz up to bat for the Aztecs.
And last time, Serna did strike him out. Hoping to do that again. Ball one.
High ball. Might hit another car. One ball, one strike, two outs. Diaz has to get on base if he wants to give his team a chance at coming back.
That is ball two. 2-1 count. Another foul ball.
High ball pitched. Three balls, one strike. Serna really trying to get into his own element, trying to make sure he doesn't throw another ball, can strike out Diaz and get his team off the field. High ball. Will it be caught? No, it will not.
It is fair.
So Diaz will get to first. Exactly what he was looking for, to keep his team alive and give him a chance at coming back in this game.
Now batting for the Aztecs, number 13, Julian Portillo.
Bertillo on his last hit was a ground out. Serna throws to first, trying to get Diaz out. Jacob Badillo up on deck next to bat. Low ball. One ball, zero strikes, two outs. That'll count as his first strike. One ball, one strike.
Another foul ball. One ball, two strikes. Serna looking for that final strike to retire the side.
Diaz will slowly steal to second. Looks to be some questions for the ump.
And right now it looks like Serna did have a balk.
Pasquadain talking to the ump, trying to find something. Didn't seem excited about the call. About the no call, excuse me.
Looks like the umps reversed the call. El Dorado fans and the El Dorado players aren't very happy about that. And there goes the coach going to talk to the umpire.
That was an awkward play as Diaz kind of jogged to second to steal it. Everyone trying to stay warm while the coaches discuss with the ump.
That's wrong. That's completely wrong.
As you can hear, fans not excited about the call. El Dorado's coach especially not excited. But Portillo will have another bat.
And
now
he
will be striked out. The Troopers will get off the field, and we'll be back soon. And we are back, bottom of the fourth. Sebastian back up to bat for the Troopers. Score is still 3-0. El Dorado has yet to get on the board through four innings.
You know, and if you're Steven, you're just really happy about that. You haven't let up a score yet, and you know, your defense is obviously helping you out in the outfield, and, you know, they're just helping you out.
Sebastian pops his hips out to avoid being hit by the ball. Fly ball. And it'll be caught. So Sebastian will be out. Close to being out of the park.
Can't lie, I thought that was going to be a home run, Alex.
The Troopers, number 19, Victor Quiñones.
Quiñones on his last bat did hit a single. He was able to make it to second before his team did count out. Far ball, but will be a foul. One strike. Will he make it to first? He will. Called safe. Quiñones hits another single.
And you know what, Alex? The Troopers have a lot of speed in almost every position. That's really helping them get on base.
Number 9, Corby Wagoner.
Wagner on his last hit, as we saw, hit the inside of the park home run, which got him and Victor home.
You know, and he's looking just to recreate that again.
And that was the last time the Troopers got points on the board, so hopefully they can recreate that. Wagner with his first strike. Do you think if you're Murillo, you're intimidated by Wagner?
I mean, after what happened last time, I think there's obviously a little intimidation there. You know, an inside the park home run doesn't happen very often, and when it does, it, you know, there's got to be some errors at somewhere on the team. So, yeah, it's just intimidated.
Two strikes, however, so Murillo looking to clap back. That will be a high pitch, however. First ball. Murillo has not had a good night. Let up 3 points. Throws it to first, trying to get Victor out. Doesn't succeed. Another low ball. Two balls, two strikes. Wagner trying to stay alive. And he will strike out Wagner. Complete opposite of what happened last time Wagner's up at bat.
And I think that helps Murillo a little bit in his confidence out there, you know. Striking out the one that brought in most of the runs this game. It really helps.
Noah Nunez up to bat. He did strike out last time. Murillo hoping to do the same thing again and get the Troopers off the field. So now they can be on offense. Victor looking to steal second, trying to be smart. And he'll run to second.
And Victor's going to get to third on that one.
And he will.
Safe.
So Nunez does get to first on his second at bat.
Now batting for the Troopers, number two, Isaiah Zamora.
Zay Zamora. As we said, played football. Pretty much a game-sealing pick against Pebble Hills. And now here, if he gets a good hit, he can bring both runners home.
Oh, yeah. You know, that's just helpful. Gives the Troopers more of a lead and gives them more of a cushion to eventually end this game.
Trying to fake out both players that are on plates. Looked to throw Victor's way, and then decided to go to Nunez and didn't throw it at all. Let's focus on Zamora. Zamora hesitates to swing.
Ball one.
Aztec fans not excited about that call.
No, they believe this should have been a strike, and at the end of the day, it's up to the umpire. And the umpires did call that a balk, which means Victor will take home.
Victor's both times he was on plate got home. So he is right now getting good points for the Troopers.
Oh, yeah, and that makes it 4-0, Troopers.
Nunez on second. Zamora up to bat with two outs. Has to be smart.
High ball. Will it be caught? Yes, it will. So the Troopers will come off the field, and we will be back to the top of the fifth. And we are back, top of the fifth. That we count as his first strike. Three more innings to go, including this one. One ball, one strike.
You know, and Serna still has a scoreless game, which is what you want to see.
The Troopers really trying to get that one seed from Americas. Last time they played Americas, they did lose 3-0, which was not the only game they didn't score any points in. They didn't score against Odessa, which was a 1-0 game.
And that is out number one. As Diego Rivera catches the ball in left field.
Americas at the moment is 4-1 in district play, with their only loss coming from Montwood, who Eastwood did beat.
For the Aztecs, number 14, Carlos Campos.
Americas the one seed.
And that is out number two. Quick out number two. With Zay Zamora getting the ground ball.
Now batting for Essex, number five, Nathan Aguilar.
Nathan Aguilar up to bat for the Aztecs.
Correction, Eastlake is our one seed at the moment. Eastwood is two and Americas is three. Eastwood's only loss coming from Americas. Eastlake at the moment undefeated.
Get out of it, baby. Count is 0-2. And that is ball one. That is ball two. 2-2 count. Serna looking for that last strike to retire the Aztecs. And that is strike three. The Aztecs are retired. Serna with another scoreless inning. We will be right back.
Rivera.
And we are back. Diego Rivera up to bat again. His last bat was a strikeout. His first bat was a walk. His first swing is asking, that might be out. But it is caught.
And very impressive catch by the El Dorado center fielder.
I thought that was going to hit the back wall, almost out even.
Batting for the Troopers, number one, Zosimo Rivera.
Diego's brother Zosimo comes out.
You know, Alex, and how would you feel if you were able to play with your brother all the way up into senior year of high school?
Well, I mean, they are twins, so that's how that works. But that'd be amazing. Zosimo's last hit was a pop out. His first hit was a single.
Trying to get on base for the third time tonight. And that is ball one.
Will he get to first? He will not.
That is out number two for the Aztecs. They're kind of...
They didn't have any more hot dogs.
Now batting for the Troopers, number 17, Gabe Rivera.
Gabe Hernandez up to bat for the Troopers. Gabe Hernandez up to bat. High ball. He swings, hits it, but it is high and behind the fence. Murillo on the mound. Two outs for the Troopers. Murillo trying to get the Troopers out quick. Gabe, high ball. Will it be caught? It will be caught. So Gabe will be out and the Troopers will be off the field. We will see the Aztecs on offense shortly. And we are back. Top of the sixth. Two more innings remaining in this ball game. That'll be a foul ball. Counters his first strike.
And you know, Alex, even though there is a
a net protecting us, I still get very scared when I see the ball coming a little bit towards me.
Oh, yeah. When we did softball, man, there was a lot coming at us. There were so many balls coming at us in softball. Zero balls. One strike. We are sorry again for some more technical difficulties, but we are back. One ball, two strikes, zero outs. Serna on the mound. That'll be a swing and a miss, and he will be striked out. First out for the Aztecs.
Now batting for the Aztecs, number four, Elijah Issa.
Turn on the mound again. Elijah Issa up to bat for the Aztecs once again. Zero balls, one strike, one out. Ground ball. Gable catch it, slides, gets it to first. Beautiful throw and catch.
That was very impressive. You know. Wow. Might have lost for words.
Gabe slid while trying to get that ball from the ground. Picks it up, gets up, and throws it to first.
Did a full 360 while he was doing the slide.
He did. Two outs for the Aztecs. One more, and they are off the field. Strike called by the rev, by the ump.
You know what, Alex? Just hearing the ball hit the catcher's mitt, it sounds like a very powerful pitch.
It does. And you know what? It makes me rethink my bet that I have with one of our own baseball players, Ryan Edens.
You know, I believe we talked about that last broadcast, but again, I say, I don't think you will get a hit off of him.
Well, I have 10 attempts to hit a ball off of Ryan's pitch, and I think I can.
I don't think you are. I think you were going to strike out every time.
We only strike out every three, so. Ground ball, and he will get it to first, and that will be out. The Troopers will get off the field once again, leaving 0 points up. We will be back at the bottom of the sixth.
Troopers number 6, Brendan Dome.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, for the bottom of the 6th.
Brandon Gomez is up to bat.
This game can very well be over in the next 2 half innings.
Yeah, Alex, and the way it's looking right now, El Dorado still scoreless through 6. Serna pitching amazingly, you know. Yeah.
Gomez on his last 2 at-bats, he did get a pop-out on each. And this one, will it be the same? It will be. It was caught, so Brandon will be out once again. Hasn't been on base once all game, but he's had an immaculate season.
And that brings up number 12. Ruben
Gutierrez. This will be his first at-bat of the night.
And he did get subbed in for Sebastian Lascurain.
That'll be a pop-up ball. Will it be caught? Yes, it... Ooh, almost Whoa. Dropped.
Woo-hoo!
Now batting for the Troopers, number 19, Victor Yunis.
Sebastian Rodriguez, the one that caught that. Almost dropped it. Kind of laughed a little bit.
And Victor Yunis, who has been on base every time, every at-bat.
And he has scored every single time he's been on base.
Hoping to recreate that once again.
Anytime he gets on base, he scores, so. Another high ball.
I believe that's going to be foul. Yes, it is.
Man, that's a scary parking lot if you think about it. There's a lot of foul balls that have gone there.
Yeah, and you know, that's why no one parks close. When you come to the Eastwood games, you see everyone parked way in the back, making sure that they don't get hit by a foul ball.
Yeah, because I'd hate to have my windshield broken. Beautiful ball right down the middle. Will it be caught, though? He catches that, diving.
I'm not going to lie, Alex. That center fielder has made some pretty impressive catches this game.
He really has. And the Troopers will come off the field, and we'll be back at the top of the 7th. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Top of the 7th. This could very well end the game right here.
3 more outs and the Troopers are victorious once again.
The Aztecs do need 5 points now if they want to keep up in this game.
You know, 5 runs in 1 inning is going to be very difficult. But anything is possible.
I don't think the Aztecs have had 5 points in a game this season. Serna trying to get him out now. Two strikes on. He gets him out there one step closer to ending this game.
That will be ball one. 1-2 count. Zero outs.
Second ball called. Foul ball.
Two count. And another foul ball. Trying to stay alive in this at bat.
Serna trying to get him out now. Third ball called.
Full count for Abraham Porido.
And he will be striked out.
Now batting for the Aztecs, number 9, Christian Diaz.
Abraham Porido has not been on base once this game. Zero
count.
Balls, one strike.
He's a
pop
high
a ball. And it'll be caught. So Diaz, will be out as well.
And one more out, and I believe this game is over, ladies and gentlemen.
Now betting for the Aztecs, number 8.
The Aztecs do need 5 points without getting a single out if they want to remain in this game. Is it possible?
You know, anything is possible, Alex, but it is going to be a very, very tough task.
I don't think it's possible.
That is ball one.
Number 7, Jacob Badillo on deck to bat next. Hoping he can get on. Hoping Portillo doesn't get out. Portillo, not really the guy they want to have at bat right now. I mean, he has a ground out and a strikeout and his only at bat.
Still hasn't gotten on base this game. You know, but I feel like Steven Serna knows that and he's just going to use it to his advantage. Although, oh, never mind, it's a 2-1 count with two outs.
Two strikes back to back. One more and this game is over, ladies and gentlemen. And he will be out. So that will end the game, ladies and gentlemen.
The final score, 5-0. Your Eastwood Troopers have won. Beat the El Dorado Aztecs.
We want to thank you guys for watching this live stream. We are coming to you from the KEHS Sports and Broadcast Network. My name is Alex Sanchez.
My name is Crab.
And we will see you guys next Tuesday, here at home for the next baseball game. Thank you.